The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th Canto, 1st Chapter, Text No. 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on May 6, 1976, in Honolulu, Hawaii.
Parikshit Maharaj is trying to understand pravritti and nivritti. Pravritti means here, in this material world, anyone who has come, beginning from Lord Brahma, down to the small hands, they have come on account of pravritti, means for enjoying sex. This is material world. So long one will be engaged in sense enjoyment in different varieties, he will have to remain within this material world. Krishna is so kind. We wanted to enjoy this material world. Therefore, He has given us full chance. Yes, you enjoy. Krishna does not want that you should enjoy this material world. That is not He. Sometimes a foolish man, they say that Krishna has given us this facility for sense enjoyment, why you shall not enjoy? Sometimes the so-called rishis and yogis, they also say, yes, when you have got the senses, it is meant for enjoyment. Why should you stop? Yes, really, it has to be stopped. If you want real life of eternal enjoyment, then you have to stop. If you don't stop, then you remain here. You have to take birth according to your desire, either as Brahma or as ant, or as a cat, or as a dog, as a demigod, and according to your capacity, Krishna will give you. All right. Vijathāvāṁ bhagavatam tiritāṁ sukhayo vajāmbhaṁ. If you want from Krishna sense enjoyment, He will give you all facilities. But Krishna does not want. Krishna said, sarva dharma parityajya, māmi tam sarva. That is His mission. That you will never be happy in this process of pravrtti-marga. Krishna bhulya jīva bhogavāṃchā kare, pāsate māyātare japotiya dhare. Māyā means the condition in which I enjoy material sense. That is called māyā. Maya, japotiya dharma. Japotiya dharma means catches. All right, come on. There are two things, light and darkness. If you remain in light, there is no darkness. And if you prefer to remain in darkness, there is no light. Two things are there. So Maya is darkness, and Krishna is light. That is our motto in the back to Godhead. Godhead is light and darkness is misery. Where there is God, there is no darkness. This is our solution. So, pravritti lakhana straiva parigunra visharomane. This is pravritti. There are different pravrittis. Sometimes some animal wants to eat something, another animal wants to eat another thing. And that is pravritti. Just like the hog, he is satisfied with stew. That is also devotee. and an enlightened human being, he is satisfied with nice halwa. So this is pravrtti. According to definitely said, pravrtti lakshana shaiva trayugunam visayodhina. Trayugunam. According to modes of nature, one is in the modes of goodness, his foodstuff is different from the person in the modes of ignorance. Therefore we find so many varieties of foodstuff, varieties of taste. This is all within this material world. It is not that sometimes this morning we are talking about vegetarian and non-vegetarian. Our mission is not to make non-vegetarian a vegetarian, no. Our mission is that either you are vegetarian or non-vegetarian, it doesn't matter. You become people. Carry on. To become vegetarian is not very good qualification. It is better than the non-vegetarian. But that is not the ultimate solution. The ultimate solution is when you become a lover of God. That is ultimate. So we are not preaching the vegetarianism. Just like there are Jains or many other religious systems, Buddhism. They are after making people vegetarian. But the law of nature is that a one living entity is the food for another living. That is the law of nature. You find even in the lower animals, they're eating one another. That is the law of nature. Ahasthani sahasthanam, apadani chatuspadam. This is the law of nature. Ahasthani, one who has no hands, he is the food. They are all animals. The animal which has no hands, just like goats and others, they have only legs. So they are food for the animals with hands. Ahasthani sahasthanam. That is the law. Apadani chatuspadam. The animals which has no leg, that means which cannot move, the plants, the grass, the trees, they cannot move. They have got legs, but they cannot move. Their legs are meant for eating. As your mouth is meant for eating, the trees, therefore, they are called pādhava. They drink water by the leg. This is God's creation. You cannot think that how it is possible to drink water by the leg. But it is God's creation, you see. You pour water on the leg of the tree, it becomes very luxuriant, healthy. So different. And so far God is concerned, he can eat with legs, he can see with hands, he can eat with eyes, that is God. That is God. Angani jasya sakalendriya vittimanti, pashtam tipaam tipaam, tiram jagat. Angani, that is transcendental. He is not under any rule. He is not under any rule. If you say, why Krishna is eating by the eyes? Yes, that is Krishna. That is Krishna. If you offer something, Krishna simply by seeing, he is eating. That is Krishna. And again, if you say, if he is eating, why the plate is full? That is Krishna. Purnasya purnamadaya purnameva visishyate. Krishna is not a hungry man like me. That if you give me something, I will eat everything. Finish. No. Krishna can take the whole prayer, still you can give the whole prayer for giving prasada. They try to understand Krishna in this way. And if you actually understand Krshna, you are liberated immediately. Janma karmamsa dhivamja me dhuyana ritakta. How Krishna is, how Krishna thinks, how Krishna was. If you understand all these things, then immediately you become liberated. Tatta deham punarjanma naiti mami. Immediately become. The only thing is, we are rocking in this material world because you do not know Krishna. That is it. You will not be admitted in the spiritual kingdom unless you know Krishna, what he is. And as soon as you understand Krishna, you are fit. Come on. Takta deham punarjanma naiti mameti kaunta. And as soon as you go, jad vatyana nivartante tad dhama paramanta. Everything is expected. And therefore Krishna comes. We are not pravrtti to enjoy this material world. Krishna comes personally, that this will not help you. He comes personally. You give up this habit. You simply surrender to me, I will take you back home, back home. This is pravrtti sangutanam nidhutte tu mahabharam. We are inclined to enjoy this material world. But if we stop this material enjoyment, we are fit for spiritual enjoyment. That is the case. Therefore Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that asaddhana purusha, asaddhana purusha dharma sasa parantapa, apraapamana nivartante nitya samsara bhakta. Asaddhana, what Krishna is speaking in the Bhagavad Gita. If we take it and let Krishna speak, I am not going to accept it. Asaddhana, there is no way in the words of Krishna. Asaddhana purusha dharma shastra, the religious system which I am speaking. What is that? Sarva-dharma-bhritta-jama-me-kaṁsa-dil-religious. So if one is neglectful, does not like this proposal, then what is the result? Apraapamana, he will never get me. Apraapamana divartante mrityu samsaravartani. Then he will have to continue this process, mrityu samsaravartani. He will take birth, again die, again take birth, again die. That is mrityu samsaravartani. So, pravrtti lakshanaschaiva trigunna visayamane jo asau alina prakite guna sattva punapana. So, we have to give up this habit that I am master, I can enjoy, I can do, I am independent. You have to give up this habit. Then, you will be eligible for going back to God. Thank you.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th Canto, 1st Chapter, text number 6, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 5th of January, 1976, in Nellore, India.
Adhuneha Mahabhaga Jathaiva narakan naraha nana ugra jasanat neyat tanmi vyakhatam arhasi. This is from Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th Canto. This is our latest publication, Srimad Bhagavatam. Therefore I am taking advantage of this publication to present before you. So in the 5th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Gosvami has given a vivid description of the Naraka planets, of the hellish condition of life. Fifth Canto, Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Gosvami has given a vivid description of the Naraka planets or the hellish planets. So, this verse I am quoting from the first chapter of Sixth Canto, that Parikshit Maharaj is asking Sukadeva Gosvami how the people suffering in hellish condition of life can be delivered. This is the beginning of the sixth chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam. At the end of the fifth chapter, Srila Sukadeva Gosvami has given description of the hellish planets. You have seen in the sky there are millions and millions of stars or planets, and they are divided into three groups. Everything is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, as it is said in the Bhagavad Gita, urdham gacchanti sattasva, meaning that those who are in the satogun, modes of goodness, they are promoted to the higher planetary system. Madhya tishthanti rajasa, those who are under the influence of passion, they remain in the middle planetary system. And those who are in the lowest grade of tamagun, adhogacchanti tamasa. So, Parikshit Maharaj, after hearing the pitiable condition of persons in the hellish planet, he became sympathetic. Therefore, he is putting the statement before Sukadeva Gosvami. Adhuneha mahabhaga jathaiva narakan nara. My dear sir, we have described about the hellish condition of the suffering persons. Now, kindly give me any enlightenment how they can be delivered. This is the symptom of a Vaishnava. Vaishnava cannot tolerate the sufferings of the humanity. Just like Prahlad Maharaj, he said before Nisimhadev, Naitat vijay paro durattaya vaitaranya. My dear Lord, I have no problem how to get delivered from this material world, because a devotee is already on the transcendental platform. It is said in the Bhagavad Gita, Mahachabhya vicharini bhakti yogi na jasevati sagunana samati taitan brahma bhuya, means anyone who is engaged in devotional service, he is already on the Brahma platform. Therefore, a devotee means he is already in the Brahma platform or spiritual platform. So, Parikshit Maharaj became very anxious how this suffering humanity can be saved. Here it is said, nana ugra jatana niyat janme vyakhatanme vyakhatum aras. Kindly give me some enlightenment how these people can be saved from this severe type of suffering. So, at the present moment, in this age of Kali, people are so fallen low that they do not know what is going to happen in the future. They are dismissing the whole problem by saying that there is no next life. This is very precarious condition of the modern civilization. So, as there are comfortable life, we can see there are discomfortable life also. So there is understanding of papa and punna, especially in the human form of life. One should know what is papa and what is punna. The human life is responsible life. We have got practical experience that if you violate the law of the state, you become criminal and punished. But if the cats and dogs are animals, they violate the law, they are not punishable. Therefore, human life must be very responsible. So, Sukadeva Gosvami said, "My dear king, if before one's next death, whatever impious acts one has performed in this life with his mind, words and body are not counteracted through proper atonement according to the description of the Manusanghita and other dharma shastras, one will certainly enter into the Hades planet after death and undergo terrible sufferings, as I have previously described." Just like in our ordinary life, if we commit some sinful activity and if we plead in the court, "My dear judge, I did not know the law," so this kind of pleading will not help him. Ignorance is no excuse. Therefore, human life is distinct from animal life. If we live in human life without caring for the supreme laws, then we are destined to suffer. Therefore, in the human society, there is a system of religion and scripture. It is the duty of the human being to understand the laws of the nature, the injunction in the shastras, and live very honestly according to the direction. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, "Jasastra vidhimutsidya vartate kamakara na siddhim sabhavnati na sukhangana parangati." Anyone who does not follow the instruction of the shastras and live whimsically as very free to act, such person never gets perfection of life, no happiness, and what to speak of going back to home, back to God. Especially in India, who are born as Indians, they have got a special facility to get this transcendental knowledge from shastras. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advised or ordered to every Indian that you make your life perfect by going through the shastras and distribute this knowledge throughout the whole world for welfare activities. The exact words in Bengali is like this: "Bharat bhumite manusya janma hoilo ja, janma sarthak kari karo paropoka." Means anyone who has taken birth in this holy land of Bharatvarsha must make his life successful by going through this shastras and distribute the knowledge throughout the whole world. Therefore, I am appealing to my Indian brothers to take up this missionary work as ordered by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Especially, my appeal is to the people of South India, because all our acharyas, Ramanucharya, Madhvacharya, Nimbarka, Vishnu Swami, Shankaracharya, they came out from South India. So, I especially request gentlemen present here to take up this Krishna consciousness movement very seriously and join with us. Death will come, we say generally, as sure as death, for our next life. Sukadeva Gosvami advises, according to our Vedic principle, before death there is a ceremony which is called prayaschitta or atonement. He advises, when a diseased man goes to a physician, the physician, after diagnosing the disease, he gives the suitable medicine. If the disease is very serious, sometimes very expensive medicine is recommended. If there is some example in the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's time, one gentleman, he was a big jamindar, landholder, he was converted into a Muslim. In those days, 500 years ago, it was not very difficult to convert a person into Muslim religion. If a Muslim would take some water from his water pot and sprinkle on the body of a Hindu, he'd become Muslim. In this way, so many people were converted into Muslim. So I'm quoting these instances in this respect because when in those days people would go to the Brahmin to take advice for atonement, they would give so severe type of atonement that it was impossible to perform. So there was the king in Bengal at that time. He was known as Nawab Hussain Shah. Formerly, he was a Mohammedan servant to a big Hindu landlord. This boy servant committed some theft, so the master punished him by striking with a cane. So the striking mark of the cane was there on his backside. So one day the Nawab's wife, Begum, saw the mark and inquired from her husband, "What is this mark?" So the Nawab described that in his childhood when he was a servant of that Hindu gentleman, Buddhimanta Khan, he beat him with that cane and that mark is there. So the wife of the Nawab, Begum Sahib, she requested that you kill this man, otherwise people will blaspheme him. The Nawab, however, declined, "No, no, this is not possible. He was my master just like my father. He chastised me. There was no fault." The wife then requested, "At least make him a Mohammedan." To satisfy his wife, he agreed, "Well, that is not a very difficult task." One day, he called Buddhimanta Khan and sprinkled the water on his body. So Buddhimanta Khan took it that he has now become a Mohammedan. So he went to the Brahmin for consultation. So when Buddhimanta Khan went to a Bhattacharya, he said that the prayaschitta is that you melt 1 kilogram of lead and drink it. So he being helpless, he went to consult another Brahmin Bhattacharya. He said, "All right, if you cannot drink molten lead, then you can drink 1 kilo of melted ghee." So in this way, when he was helpless, he went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knew the situation of the then society. He therefore advised him that you better give your family life, you go to Vrindavan. He advised him that go to Vrindavan, live there and chant Hare Krishna. So the difficulty is, in the shastras, there are atonement for prayaschitta, not like that you drink hot ghee or hot lead, but there are prayaschittas, so one has to execute that. So when Sukadeva Gosvami recommended, "My dear king, you are very anxious for this person suffering in the hell, they have to perform prayaschitta." So Sukadeva Gosvami, after recommending this, could not satisfy Parikshit Maharaj. He was king, Kshatriya, he knew the nature of the citizen. Therefore he said, "Dishta sutabhyam jat papam janan api atmano ahitam karoti bhuya vivasa prayaschitta matvokatam." Maharaj Parikshit said, "One may know that sinful activity is injurious for him, because he actually sees that a criminal is punished by the government and rebuked by people in general, and because he hears from the scriptures and learned scholars that one is thrown into hellish condition in the next life for committing sinful act. Nevertheless, in spite of such knowledge, one is forced to commit sins again and again, even after performing acts of atonement. Therefore, what is the value of such atonement? Prithvij Maharaj was ruler, the king. He knew everything practically, that so many citizens committing criminal acts were imprisoned and punished. Still they, after coming back from the jail, prison house, again committed. So, on the whole, Parikshit Maharaj did not like the process of prayaschitta is beneficial, ultimately beneficial to the people. That we get experience by two methods, by seeing and by hearing. Just like a criminal, a thief, he has seen that previously a man who stole, he was arrested by the police and punished. And he has heard also from authorities, from lawyers, that stealing is bad. If you are arrested, he will be put into the prison. So this is the defect of the modern civilization, that they are enacting so many laws to stop criminal, but the criminality is increasing. The practical example is, when you go to the airport, there is security checking. So all gentlemen, whoever he may be, sometimes they excuse me, but they are checked thoroughly. So the authorities check everyone means that everyone is dishonest. What is the value of this education if everyone is criminal and dishonest? So Parikshit Maharaj is intelligent devotee. He therefore protested against this so-called atonement. Therefore, he describes like this, Dishtas sutabhyam tat papam janan api atmano ahitam. Everyone knows that I am stealing, it is not good for me. But even though he is put into the jail as prayaschitta, again he comes back and does the same thing, that what is the meaning of this legal punishment or prayaschitta? Therefore, Parikshit Maharaj says that kochit nivartate abhadrat kochit charati tat punaha prayaschitta atho upathya aparthya manne kunyara saucava. He gave a very good example that this prayaschitta or legal punishment is like kunyara saucava. Kunyara means elephant and saucha taking bath. So, kunyara, the elephant, dips itself into the water and takes bath very thoroughly. And as soon as it comes on the land, it takes some dust and throws over its body. Purpose is that unless one is fully convinced that sinful activities are very, very abominable for me, he cannot give it up. Therefore, one has to cleanse his heart. That is real prayaschitta. Otherwise, even being imprisoned or giving fine or suffering, one cannot cease from sinful activity. This Krishna consciousness movement is thoroughly, wholesale process of cleansing the mind. Therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given his own version, Cheta Dharpana Mahajanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nidvapanam. The purpose is a long verse, that by chanting Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam, if we perform this Krishna Sankirtan, then immediately our core of heart, which is filled up with all dirty things, will be cleansed. For example, you can see practically, all my disciples present here, they are coming from Western countries, Europe, America, or even in India, Parsis and other Mohammedans, they are coming. But they are now pure, cleansed of all dirty things. In this movement, throughout the whole world, there are at least 10,000 to 12,000 devotees like that. And before this life, they were addicted to all kinds of sinful life. We have summarized all sinful activities into four groups, namely illicit sex, meat eating, intoxication and gambling. So all these 10,000 to 12,000 men who are now attached with this Krishna consciousness movement, they are not committing these four pillars of sinful life. Therefore our request is that you take to this chanting method. It is very easy. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. And gradually you shall become free from all sinful reaction of life. But one thing we must be very careful, that we should not commit again sinful life. Chant Hare Krishna mantra, you become free immediately from all sinful reaction. But if you commit again sinful life, that is your responsibility. 10 kinds of offences. One offence is very grievous offence. Namnad vala jasahi papa buddhi. If one thinks that I am chanting Hare Krishna, therefore whatever sinful acts I am doing, it is becoming counteract. If you keep yourself on the platform of chanting Hare Krishna mantra and do not commit willfully and again sinful life, then you are liberated. So not only mukti marga, if you keep yourself always pure, do not commit any sinful activity and chant Hare Krishna mantra, then your life is successful. Don't commit the mistake of the elephant that take bath thoroughly and again come and throw dust on your body. I think I shall end tonight this year. Thank you very much.
Next is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th Canto, 1st Chapter, text number 7, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on May 8, 1976, in Honolulu, Hawaii.
Sukadeva Gosvami said, my dear king, if before one's next death, whatever impious act one has performed in this life, with the mind, words and body are not counteracted through the proper atonement, according to the description of the Manusanghita and other dharma shastras, one will certainly enter the hellish planet after death and undergo terrible suffering, as I have previously described to you. So, atonement is prescribed in every scripture. Even in Christian Bible there is atonement. So, in other scriptures also there is atonement. Just like a man who has committed murder, he must die, life for life. This is atonement. When the government punishes a murderer with capital punishment, death, that is a mercy upon him. That punishment is accepted practically all over the world from time immemorial. So, there must be atonement. So if a person who has committed murder, killed somebody else, then if he is punished by death, then the sinful activity which he has committed, that is counteract. Otherwise, he will have to suffer next life very severely, 4 times. The people do not believe even in the next life and want to seek out atonement and punishment.
that gets in darkness, otherwise, they would have been, they would have followed actually the injunction of the Shastra. First of all, one should not be killing anyone. In the Bible also it is said, thou shalt not kill. Why it is forbidden? Because if he kills, he will have to suffer. But they do not care for it, therefore they suffer. So Sukadeva Gosvami says that whatever punishment are described in the Third Canto on account of different sinful activities, one has to suffer that. Unless he commits, unless he performs at all. This is the Nachet Ihaiva Bhachitin Jatan Hasa Kutasakudyan Manokti Panhi. We can commit sinful activities in different ways. Mana, even by mind, we can commit sinful activities. If I contemplate something sinful by my mind, then we become affected. Therefore, we must keep always sinless. Kāyamāna bhākya, this sannyas tridanda, there are three rods within the state, I recall. Three dandas, not three, four. Three is kāya, body, mind, kāyamāna, and world. And one is personal. Therefore, there are four sticks within the dandas. Those who have taken sannyas, they know it. That the idea is that I surrender to my spiritual master or Krishna. Spiritual master is identical with Krishna because he gives true knowledge. Therefore, he is as good as God. Akshad Haritena Samastha Sastri Uttastha Thabhava. Spiritual master is considered directly as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Sakshat, Sakshat means direct. Why? Because he is Jnana Prada. He gives knowledge, real knowledge. That is the qualification of Supreme. Nobody can become a spiritual master if he has no knowledge. If he is a speculator, he cannot become a spiritual master. He must gain the right knowledge. Then he is bona fide spiritual master. Other is a bogus, jnana prada. And without real knowledge, our life is useless. Just like this morning, we are talking so many things. They have no standard knowledge, no real knowledge. They do not know anything. Still, they present themselves, pretend themselves as philosophers, scientists, as guru, as father. No. Everyone, those who are guardians, therefore Shastra has forbidden. Guru na sasyat, sajano na sasyat, pita na sasyat, janani na sasyat. One should not become a guru. One should not become a relative. One should not become the father. One should not become the mother. One should not become the husband. In this way, there is a list. Why? Namo chayirja samukhi samitthun. If he does not know how to guide his disciple or subordinate to stop the cycle of birth and death, he should not do that. This is the ultimate. goal of life, that we have to stop this cycle. Punarjanma jayaya, to conquer over next birth. Punarjanma jayaya. When Visharutra Muni went to see Maharaj Dasaratha to ask the help of Lord Ramchandra and Lakshman, there was a demon, they were disturbing in the forest. The same persons were disturbed. They could kill that demon. But because they were Brahmins, saintly persons, they did not like the killing business in their own hands. That was the system. A Brahmana will not kill. A Brahmana simply by cursing, one he can kill. Doesn't require him to open. Just like Maharaj Parikshit, he was cursed by a boy Brahmana, that within 7 days he will be bitten by a snake and he will die. The Brahmanas were so fast. The Brahman is not Joe. And Kali Yuga, there is no such Brahman. So, this Vishwamitra Muni came to Maharaj Dasarath to request that send your son Ramchandra and Lakshman to kill this demon. Kshatriya business. Chap, chap means injury. If somebody is injuring your body, it is the duty of the government to save you. Why unnecessarily you are injuring you? Just like Parikshit Maharaj, when he was going, and some person was Sudra in the dress of a king, he was trying to kill a cow. Immediately, Parikshit Maharaj took his sword. Who are you, rascal? You are trying to kill a cow in my kingdom. That is Kshatriya. The tree has taken birth. The man has taken birth. Why simply man should be saved, not the cow, not the tree? He must be saved. This is the government thing. Unnecessarily, there cannot be any killing. Lord Christ also, thou shalt not kill. Yes, this is the beginning of religious life. If you are accustomed to kill somebody, either man, animal, tree, fish, anything, there is no entrance in religious life. There is no entrance. Because everyone, every living entity is son of God. Sarva-jonishu. You have read Bhagavad Gita. Sarva-jonishu. And all sources of birth. Sarva-jonishu. Sambhavanti murtaya. There are different forms of life, 8,400,000. They are all living entities. But according to karma, they have got different bodies. This is the difference. Just like we have got different dresses, according to my choice. Similarly, we get different bodies according to my choice. This morning, we are talking about the sufferer, what is called? The sea sufferer? Serpent. Yes. Serpent. I call sufferer. Sea sufferer. The sea surfer, it is practical. Because we are creating a situation by which you shall become a fish. Yes? Contamination, just like if you purposely contaminate some disease, you must suffer from that disease. Karanam guna sangasya sada sad janma junishu in the Bhagavad Gita. Why there are different varieties of life? But what is the reason? That reason means karana. Krishna says in the Bhagavad, karanam guna sangasya Savasat janma jyonishu. Prakriti kriyamanani. Prakriti sthopi pudusa. Bunjanti tadguna. So, the reason is, as you are infecting, the nature's law is so perfect that if you infect something, some disease, some contamination, then you must have. This is nature's law, automatically going on. Karanam gunasangas. So there are three modes of material nature. Goodness, passion and ignorance. So long we are in this material law. Purusha prakriti sthopi bhunjante tad guna. If we remain in certain place, we must be affected by the modes of that place. So there are three modes, sattva-gun, rajo-gun. We have to associate either with the modes of goodness or with the modes of passion or with the modes of ignorance. Now, 3 into 3, it becomes 9. 9 into 9, it becomes 81. The mixture, just like colors, there are 3 colors, blue, red and yellow. Now, those who are experts in manufacturing, called artists, they mix these 3 colors in different way, and they display. Similarly, according to the gunas or mixture, association, karanam guna-sangasya, we get different types of body. Therefore, we see so many varieties of body. The karanam guna-sangasya. So, the person who is taking very much pleasure, dancing in the sea like fish, so he is contaminating that mode of nature. So that in next life he will become a fish. He will be very free to dance with you. Now it will take again millions of years to come to this stage of human. Jalajana mulakhani sāvara lakhani. He has to pass through the fish life. There are 900,000 different species of life. Then you again come to the land, you become trees, plants and so on. 2 million different forms you have to go through, that is evolution. There is fear of evolution, that is not perfectly explained. It is explained in the Vedic literature. So just a tree is standing for 10,000 of you. We have to pass through these lands. But there is no perfect knowledge. We are thinking, and not very, very nice American body or Indian body. No. It took so many years to come to this life. Therefore, Shastra says, Lamsya Sudullavamidam Bahusam Bhavanti. He about this human form of life. After many, many millions of years waiting, so do not misuse it. That is Vedic civilization. Not to misuse the human form of life. Nature's law is very, very strict. This life, it is given a chance. Nature gives a chance. Now, you get this human form of life, we advance consciousness, now we make further improvement. That is it. From here, we can make further improvement. What is that further improvement? We can go to the better planets. There are many better planets, you can go there, heavenly planets, where you can live for 10,000 of years. 10,000 of years, and that is also not our year. The higher planetary system, there 1 day, our 6 months. In that way you can live there for 10,000 of years. And the standard of living condition is thousand times better. Therefore it is called heaven. If you like, you can go there. Buddham gacchanti sattvastha, jati deva bhata devan, everything is explained. If you can go, if you like, you can go to the Kithiri Loka. If you want to remain here as human being, you can also remain here. But you have to work for it, to keep your position, status. Just like if you become rich man, high standard of life, you have to maintain it. Not that it will continue automatically. No, that is not possible. This is material world is not like that. You get one position and it will continue. No. A little discrepancy immediately deteriorates your position. So you have to maintain it. So if you want to maintain yourself within this bhulok, there are above this bhulok, bhuvalok, janalok, tapolok, maholok, there are so many Platonic systems. And down also, tal, atal, nital, patal, talatal, like that. If you want to go down, you can go down. If you want to go up, you can go. Everything is there, you can do. Only that anyone can understand that in the human society, if you want to become high court judge, you can become. And if you want to become a criminal in the prison house, you can become. Everything is open. Not that government says that you become a criminal and he prefers somebody, you become a high court. No. Everything is in your hand. If you like, you can become. So, similarly, if you like, you can go back to home, back to God. That is what they say. And if you don't like, then remain here. Therefore Krishna says, aprapamam nivatnanti nityu samsara vatpare. Krishna has come to you to give you nice instruction. How you can go back to home, back to God. Back to home, back to God. That is Krishna's mission. Pritranam sadhanam vinasaya sadhiskritam. He comes himself, Krishna, and he comes as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, as devotee of Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna. And because people misunderstood, the Krishna is asking, sarva-dhammān parityajya, māṁ ekaṁ saraṇaṁ bhaja, this rascal thought that it is too much. Why I shall surrender to Krishna? I am also as good as Krishna. That is our mentality. If somebody says, good man, that you surrender, I shall give you good instruction. Why shall I surrender? That is material life. But our this Krishna consciousness movement begins when you are ready to surrender. That is beginning. Tadviddhi pranipātena. Pranipāt means surrender. Pratistha rūpena nipā. Yes, I surrender. That is the beginning. Bhavanam janmanamante jnanavanamana prabhadrati. To learn this surrender, it will take many, many births. Bhavanam janmanam. But those who are intelligent, they will surrender immediately. Krishna says surrender, why not? Krishna is the Supreme Lord. Let me tell you. Then his life is successful. Immediately. Within a second, his life is successful. But we are not prepared to surrender. That is our material disease. So, if we do not surrender to Krishna and take his instruction and make our life, that is our choice. But if you like, you can make your life successful within a moment, simply by surrendering. Thank you very much.
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th Canto, 1st Chapter, Text Number 8, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on May 9, 1976, in Honolulu, Hawaii.
So, there are different varieties of sinful activities, just like there are different varieties of diseases. So, become disease is not our normal life. To remain healthy is our normal life. When we become disease, that is abnormal condition of life, therefore we want to treat, get out of the disease. Similarly, this material life is the disease condition of the living being. We are all living beings, but because we have accepted this material body, we are suffering. Matra sparsha ko devas citosna sukha dukkha. Now, we require this fan. Why? Because feeling some pains on account of heat. That heat is felt by the body, not the soul. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita it is said, Matra sparsha kaunteya sitasna sukha dukkha. This material pains and pleasure, they are simply touching this body, not the soul. Soul is always aloof. It's like we are on a car. Suppose there is some accident, the car is broken, but not the person, the driver is broken. The car is broken. But because the driver or the proprietor of the car is too much adhered to the car, when the car is broken, his heart fails. Actually, the person has nothing to do with the car. But because he is too much attached to the car, when the car is broken, he thinks, I am finished. Heart is broken. Like that. So, we are part and parcel of God, every one of us. So, we remain always pure. But account of material attachment, we are suffering. This is the position. So therefore, the disease condition of our present life has to be treated. What is the treatment? To become detached. On account of attachment, we are suffering. But, detachment. So this detachment, there are many different processes of becoming detached. Karma yoga, jnana yoga, dhyana yoga, and many other processes. But the most perfect process is bhakti yoga. Bhakti yoga, that is stated, Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayodita Janayati Yasu Vairagya. If one is trained up to become devotee of Vasudeva Krishna, Vasudeva means Krishna. Vasudevi Bhagavati, Vasudev is the Supreme Personality, Bhagavan, Bhagavati. Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yogam Prayajita. If we engage ourselves in the bhakti yoga process to Vasudeva, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then what happens? Janayati asu vairagyam. Then very soon one becomes detached, vairagya. The bhakti yoga means vairagya vidya, how to become detached, that is the test. Whether I am making progress in the bhakti yoga, the test is within yourself. You haven't got to take a certificate from others. How much you are becoming detached to this material world? That is the test. If you are still attached to the material pleasure, that means you are not making progress in working. It is a test. Just like bhakti parishan bhava virakti under parishan. You see, vairagya vidya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, by his example of life, you are 24 years young boy, and he had a very beautiful 16 years old wife, very affectionate mother. In the family, two persons, the mother and the wife, if they are very, very good, then they happy life. In the Chanakya Pandit therefore say, Mātāraśya grihīnāśti bhājyāśya priyavādini arannam tenagantatvam jathārannam tathāgriham. At home, if one has no mother, and if his wife is not very, apriyavādini, does not speak very well. Wife is meant for speaking very well to the husband. That is the husband and wife relationship. So Chanakya Pandit said, if the wife is not very attached and does not speak very well, then does not like the husband or the home. If such wife is at home and mother is not there, this is ideal Indian happy home. But in your country it is very rare, you see. But this is the standard of happiness. So if there is no mother and there is no good wife, then Aranlam Tehragantasma, immediately he should give up the home. Aranyam, he should go to the forest. Why? Forest, the city, I have got very nice home, nice building. No, for a person who has no good wife, neither mother, for him, jatharanyam tathagriham. For him, either this home or the forest, it is same. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had these two greatest attachments at home. Very affectionate mother, he had read about Suchi Mata's, because he was the only, out of his 10 children, only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was the living child of Suchi Mata. So, naturally, she was very, very affectionate to his son, and this Vishnupriya wife, very, very affectionate, beautiful, young, but he gave up. This is called vairagya vidya. No attachment. Although there is reason of attachment, but he had no attachment. Takta sudhastana sudhe sudharajya thing.
Ramnishtri Adhubhatasa Jadagadanandam Maya Mridam Daitai Sitamannadhava Bandi Mahapurusati Charanar. He left home for the benefit of the whole human society. This is Vairagya. Similarly, the Goswamis, they are ministers, they are not ordinary men. Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami. Practically, they were governing the whole affairs of government at that time, a very exalted post. So about them also, it is written by Srinivasa Acharya, Tatta Thunam Asesa Mandala Patisane Sada Tucha. Asesa Mandala, Mandala Pati means big, big leaders, big, big leaders of the society. He was minister, so he was associating with big, big men, not ordinary men. But he gave up. In such a position, minister drawing a high salary and association, all the big, big men of the country or of the society. But he gave them up, so they asked Purushava. What is the use of this? This is called Baila. Daktya Turnam, very good. Daktya Turnam, Asesa Mandala Purushi. Not only one, many, many big men were flattering them. Kapatunam Asesa Mandala Padisane Sada Tuchava. Then what he began? Bhutya Dina Ganesha Kaukarunaya Kopira Kantasuda. They are so affectionate for the poor suffering souls. Bhutya Dina Ganesha Kaukarunaya. So Vaishnava is very, very merciful. They are merciful to the fallen soul. Their only concern is how to deliver these fallen souls. They are under the clutches of Maya, suffering. So, various means adopting, just try to save them. This is Vaishnava business. Nāna-śāstra-vichāra-naiko-nipunau sad-dharma-samasthāpakau lūkānāṁ-hita-kārīnau. This Goswami, they were studying so many books, Vedic literature, and found out the cream, how to establish Nāna-śāstra-vichāra-naiko-nipunau sad-dharma-samasthāpakau. Sadhana, not cheating dharma, dharma means real, really. So, the sadhana, as soon as we become addicted to sinful activities, then our real constitutional position we forget. We become mad after it, and the disease increases. So here it is suggested that according to the disease are there, different types of disease. Some disease is very acute and some disease is not very important. So he suggests that tasmāt pura iva ca iha pāpa-nikhi niṣkṛtau jatita mṛttu ravibhadda ātma. You have to die. That is a fact. Nobody will live here. They are sure as that. So before death, we must finish the atonement of our sinful activities. This is recommended. Pura. tasmat pura eva iho, papa niskrito. But nobody knows that the present moment, they do not know what is papa and how to get out of it, what is next birth. Everything is unknown at this point. This is the modern civilization. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took one thing, that śrīta-dārpaṇa mārjanam, they are in gross misunderstanding of life. So, in order to cleanse their heart, to understand what is the position, where they are going, where they are actually, how things are going on, it is due to ignorance. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu say that śrīta-dārpaṇa mārjanam, unless we cleanse our heart of all the dirty things that we have accumulated, then we have to continue the sufferings of this material world. But if we cleanse, we understand what is our position. The position is that we are part and parcel of God. If God is good, we are also good. Just like gold, and particle of gold. If gold is valuable, the little particle, it may be less valuable, but it is valuable, it is not an ordinary thing. Similarly, we living entities, mamaivam sajiva bhuta, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, that this, all these living entities, they are my part and parcel. Means as good as I am. Faith that mana sasthani indriyani prakriti sthanika, he is concocting, he is manufacturing ideas to become happy. Mana sasthani indriyani, and with his senses he is trying to satisfy himself. But because he has no information how to become happy, mana sasthani indriyani prakriti sthani karasati. Karasati means that is struggle for existence. That struggle for existence is explained by different scholars and philosophers in different ways, but actually there is struggle for existence, and they are trying to be happy, manufacturing different types of struggle for existence. The other day, who was saying that they have now discovered another way of happiness, flying in the air? Yes. Now the sufferers are suffering, what is called? That is not sufficient. Now they want to fly. Another discovery. This is the manasasthani indriyani prakriti sthani karsati. Actually, they are manufacturing different ways of suffering. And there is no happiness. They simply, the business is going on, manufacturing different ways of suffering. So, therefore, that is disease. This is our material disease. And it is recommended here that before the next death, if we come to the right conclusion, how we shall become happy, then this process of continuously dying and again taking birth and again disease and again old age, then it is not very good. But there are so fools and askers, they do not know how the life is going on, how nature is working upon us. Everything is a darkness. Therefore, Krishna consciousness is the only hope for humanity. Only hope. It is not a story, it is fact. So those who have come to Krishna consciousness, I request that take it very seriously, and read the books and make progress and simply try to understand Krishna, and then everything, all problems will be solved. Thank you very much.